The next table is information taken from Fracfocus, a voluntary chemical registry maintained by the Groundwater Protection Council. It lists the chemicals and the amounts used on a particular frac job. The information was provided by an operator and lists the component, ingredient, purpose, and amount as a percent composition by mass for the total. As can be seen, fresh water is the main ingredient, with some recycled water added. Sand is the next largest ingredient, followed by acid and friction reducer. In general, it is the ingredients with the lowest overall mass that present the most concern from an environmental perspective. This includes the corrosion inhibitors, biocides, and scale inhibitors. So what is the purpose of the chemicals? Each one has a specific purpose. Acid removes near well damage and cleans up perforations of cement prior to the actual injection of the fracturing fluid. Biocides control bacterial growth in fluids to prevent clogging and reduced performance. Corrosion inhibitors prevent corrosion of the pipe. Friction reducers decrease pumping friction in the pipe and in the created fractures. Gelling agents improve proppant placement and produce a higher viscosity for proppant delivery. The next table is again from the same well, but now shows the toxicity of the ingredients. One measure of toxicity listed in the table is the European Union Swiss poison class, which is a numeric value from 1 to 5. The smaller the value, the more toxic the ingredient. A low value means the ingredient is toxic in small quantities. 3 is the lowest value in this table and is attributed to petroleum distillates, 2-butoxyethanol, quaternary ammonium compounds, and methanol. Friction reducers, corrosion inhibitors, biocides, and scale inhibitors. Probably the biggest concern for these ingredients and the environment is handling of the concentrated forms on the surface in terms of transport to the well pad and on-site handling of the bulk chemicals during mixing and injection. The next table explains in a little more detail the EU Swiss poison class scheme. This next table shows where these same chemicals are used in other industries and in other applications. What's shown here are the components on the left, again, particularly those that cause the most environmental concern, the actual ingredients in those components, and then where these same ingredients are used in other products. So, for instance, with friction reducers, these things are often used in water treatment and in paint supplies. Iron control, citric acid is used commonly as a food additive. Corrosion inhibitors, things like ethylene glycol, dimethyl formamide, isopropanol, are used in a variety of products, including automotive antifreeze, production of acrylic fibers and plastics, pharmaceutical applications, gasoline additives, precursors to perfume, solvents in paints, whiteboard cleaners, and cosmetics. Biocides are commonly used in alcoholic drinks, in disinfectants, and in sterilization for medical equipment.